Hello, ladies and gentlemen! Welcome back to Astral Games Day 168. Now, for those of you... And I must move my camera. Beep! Flying across the screen. For those of you who are looking this up on YouTube and saying... Looking at the Dark Souls playlist and are like, welcome back! Where did the other parts go? This Astral Games Day 168 was actually meant as a Banner Saga 2 episode where I would play and finish Banner Saga 2. I didn't know how long it would last, so that's why I started earlier than my usual stream time. But it appears I would have just finished it if I had done a 4-hour stream because we're finished, but we still have some time left. I am going to dedicate some time to trying and killing the Red Vanguard, which is the boss we're on right now on Dark Souls 2. So that's why you will not see any... Well, you saw the pause screen at the beginning, and you do not see any other Astral Games Days 168s above that. This is because this is a extra ending to a episode that was actually dedicated to a different game. So it's one part, if you see one part of me finding the Red Vanguard, you're good. Because this Dark Souls part will only last one part. Astral Games Days 168 Dark Souls is only one part on YouTube. One movie, one video. There you go, that was it for the YouTube people. Enjoy, hopefully. And for those on Twitch, welcome back. I hope you guys had a good break, had used some of that break for good purposes. And, oh god, here we go. Red Vanguard. Holy shit. It's not a fun boss. It's not a fun boss. The other bosses I somehow enjoyed for some reason, but this one is getting terribly annoying. But then again, I know the payoff. And if you do beat such a boss in Dark Souls, I do know the feeling of eventual victory. So, I shall remain strong. Alright, re. Uh-oh. Stupid statues. Nice. To surround it. Astral level 69. Insert loot emote here. Yeah, I don't think I have a loot emote on this channel. But we do have enough emotes supported in that sense. That there's probably a loot emote somewhere you can use. Where is that guy? Come on. I forgot the damn emotes. Oh, he appeared. There he is. See, I lost. There is a exclamation emote command. Are you still using the Falchion? Yes, I am. It's a +5 Falchion or something. It's pretty darn good. I like the weapon. Just the stamina cost can be. But I think 2 swings per attempt is good. Nycro, thanks for the host. How you doing, sir? Yeah, 2 swings and then shield up again. Shit. Don't get greedy. I think that's the way forward. Thank you. Ooh, that statue helped, but it was still a kill. Uh-oh. Hello. That's fine. Basically a flip tank. Yeah, that's because of my... Oh, there he is. It's basically because of my War Thunder playthrough. Oh, yeah! Holy shit! Okay, didn't expect that to happen. Philos, how are you doing? Excited for Gamescom. Excellent. I'm not going this year, but... So not sure it's funny or applaudable? Oh, yeah, but it's because of my... my 24-hour streams in Carriers, where I played War Thunder. Oh, you mean that? Yeah. Well, I did it a lot. I know that much. Okay, I thought this was going to be an hour of annoying Red Vanguard attacks, but... there you have it. Second... Well, Syncarius, hold on. Second try of this stream. There have been a lot of tries last stream. I think I tried the entire final part plus maybe a bit of the third part of the stream. I think maybe 1.5 to 2 hours of trying last stream. Yes. I want to level up.
Level up!
Sure, we have souls enough for 4 levels. Yeah, 4 levels. Ooh. Throat infection. Oh no! Feel better soon, Philos. Let's see. Some figure, some endurance, maybe some vitality and attunement. Why not? No, adaptability, that was the one. Adaptability. People said adaptability is good. That's true, right? Adaptability is good to have, right? That was a thing. I heard people say adaptability was good. So getting a single raise in all these base stats seems good. Red Vanguard is ripped, which means stream is done. No, it's not Syncarius. I'll make this hour an entire hour. No worries. Oh no, Philos. Hope you feel better soon. More stamina. Isn't that endurance? Yeah, that's endurance, right? I'm doing more stamina. I just think a across-the-board upgrade of all my base stats is a good way to go. Because we don't have a particular weapon at this moment that we're like, I want to wield that one. So there's not a particular stat that I'm chasing after. So maybe getting a upgrade across the board is good. At least I think so. And I think adaptability was the one people said this, the stat you need to go for. I wanna upgrade my Estus. Stupid Estus. Alright. Wait, this is the entrance? This is where we continued, right? This is the room we fought him in. Okay, that's fine. That's all fine and dandy. Oh, there is a path forward. Okay, phew! Luckily. More stamina has become a running joke for this run. Wait, what? going to avoid the stone pillars. Who knows what the traps leading. Oh, hello. A talking rat. You don't look so good, sir.
Leave this place, human. We have no time for thy kind. Humans bring nothing but filth.
Really? The rat says humans bring nothing but filth. Really?
Is that a rat tale, human? Thou'st one of mine rat burrows conquered. This will not go unnoticed. Rejoice, for the right to serve me is now thine. Since thou'rt human still, permit me ask, wilt thou thy human soul surrender and pledge thyself to me? Swearest thou by the sweet-tempered sludge that laps at our bosoms?
Abandon your covenant and join the Rat King covenant. Talking rat, anyone can cook. Chick looks with his ears, small weapon types to offer. Oh, maybe we can do that next time, you know, we get there. Rat King Covenant? It's interesting that this game does not explain you what the covenants are. No, I'm fine with my covenant.
Of course, humans are all alike. Get thee gone. We will tolerate thy stench no longer.
You stink.
Thou returnest.
He's a pretty cool though.
I am not unkind. Shouldst thou forbear thy ways, audience shall be thine. Swearest thou to serve me true?
Oh.
Then we need consort no longer.
In order to access NPC, you need to join his covenant. Right. My current covenant? I have no idea. Way of the Blue or something? It's the night guy that sat by the tower. Something with blue. Blue Sentinels? Way of the Blue. It was the guy with the tower in Majula. Yeah, this doesn't look ominous at all. Sure, we'll drop down. Because, you know, skeleton. Oh, a Pharaoh's Lockstone. Ah, I see. I see it. Just have to be really careful. Crusader Stronghold. Oh yeah, in Stronghold there's a Rat King. That's true. Rat King and a Wolf King and all that. Man, that game was amazing. Oh! Stronghold 1 was amazing. I'm glad we just spent our souls. The blatant disregard of gravity made by that skeleton, yeah. I'm glad we just spend our souls. So we don't have to worry about that anymore. Is he attached on something? Doesn't seem to be attached either. Oh wait! Nope. I thought that was like a rope between the ribs, but it doesn't seem that way. There is a blatant disregard for gravity by a skeleton. We must report this to the rightful authorities. Hey. Oh, the souls are there. How kind of the game to put the souls in a place where we can easily reach them. Wait, and now we have to drop down? There doesn't seem to be... Yeah, this is the only path. That doesn't... That still doesn't seem to be safe. Maybe if we equip the... Pig, snake, you play this lion. Yeah, yeah, and the wolf one was the, there we go. Hurrah! Boom! Ah, just kidding. All the shiny blue things in the darkness. Yep. Bleedstone? What the heck is a bleedstone? Till to offer to the Rat King. Huh. We didn't offer it. Huh, it's not in the usual inventory slot. Is it the ring? Nope. Nope. Bleedstone makes equipment lacerating. An altered state of titanite, used to make weapons lacerating, or to provide bleeding reduction to shields. Sorcerers at the Melfian Magic Academy once attempted to imbue titanite with various elements, but are said to have failed. Someone must have succeeded, though. What else would explain this stone? Interesting. Right, so let's see where we are. Ugh. Without dropping down too much. We need to drop down again. There's no way directly down. But if we drop down on the bridge, we have a chance of falling in the hole. Dropping down on that side seems safer. There is a chest there, though, that I might want to investigate. And a item. And there is the way forwards. Supposed to represent a person in history since I was technically Richard the Lionheart. Snake was Saladin. Yeah, maybe, maybe. I think that gap is jumpable on the bridge, though. I'm gonna drop on this end. I think the gap in that bridge is jumpable. Nope! If you press the right button. Oh, great! Oh! Yeah, there are more of them. Cool. Wait, didn't I jump? That's not the jump button. Wasn't there like a leap somewhere? Or is there only a roll? Wait, what? Wait, this character doesn't have a leap? You had a leap in Dark Souls 1, as far as I can remember. How the heck? Why does it roll? Why does it roll? Left stick is just... Oh! Aha! There we go. There we go, now we know. I see. I totally forgot that part. We still have the cat ring equipped. No, we don't. It's fine though. There's gradual HP restoration. Now we have to do this part again. Oh wow! If you don't equip that ring, it's a heck of a lot more painful. Choose to roll while running instead of force jump in one. I see. Oh, it's one of those things. Yeah, unfortunately. So, left stick is jump. There we go. You're not a mimic, sir. No. Cool. And there's a trap in it. No, there's not. Cool. Ash knuckle ring. Okay. No, I definitely want that one. What does ash knuckle ring do? Increases petrification resistance. If the game gives you a petrification resistance ring. Okay, I'm going to ignore that item for a moment and check up here. If I don't roll, miss, but I do. Shit. I could still chase it and kill it and take whatever it has. I could have, but then I would have fallen down without giving the... without getting the ring. Gosh dang darn it. Gonna be a wait, what? Oh, just catching up on what happened. Good thing now is I can drop on the right side and ignore the chest altogether and just check out the door. I can just drop here and just check out what this is. Let's see what this is. Alright, it's an item. Homeward bone. The game is like, yeah, you don't want to go here. Not even the rings of cat falling will save you from this one. Here's a homeward bone. Try battle deck next time. Oh wait, is this... Guys, I think this is the well. From Majula. Wait, what on the thing about you saying... Oh, if the game gives you a petrification ring, you know you have to put it on. Pretty much. Alright, with that out of the way. I can jump bridges. Disc chime. What the heck is a disc chime? I guess it's a charm. A rare secret chime of unknown origin can be used as a shield. This chime likely brought here by the visiting saint slightly augments the effects of miracles. Use strong attack to emit miracles and hexes. A shield charm? The frick? A shield that is also a charm? Oh, I need 18 fate to use it effectively. Okay. You haven't fought any gorgons or anything? I just have it equipped, alright? I'll just have it equipped, just in case. Oh, whoops. Why did I use Estus? I don't know. Bring it on, explode, you guys. Oh, wow. They are more dangerous exploding than the other explodey guys. Alright. Are you done? Oh, with bone. Game is like, nope, you really should turn back and go home. Great heal. Great heal. This game is like, put some ball points in the fate, yo! 28 fate, holy. We only have 12. I definitely want 18 for that shield, though. If that's a shield and a charm. Okay, there's a knight there. Let's check out the unknighted part first. Don't have to pull up my charm every time I, Oh, no. 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 Blighttown 2.0. This is Blighttown 2.0. Shit. Are you kidding me? No. This game has I rage quit. I'm gonna rage quit. If this turns out to be Blighttown 2.0. Let me guess, Dark Souls 3 has another Blighttown area? Because the creator thought Blighttown was the best area they ever made in a freaking game. Blighttown is best out. Ugh. It's terrible. Like, what sort of design school did the designer of Blighttown go to? It is just freaking terrible. And all this for a chest. DG, you need help, yeah. A token of spite. Oh, there is a way forward, alright. Let's check out token of spite first. Token of spite. Token of... Token recognizing that the owner has traveled worlds to defeat others. When used, you are more likely to summon invaders from other worlds for a period of time. Simply carrying these tokens shows the bitterness of the grudges of the holder as accumulated. An astral. Time to look for the ring that gives you poison resistance. Yeah, pretty much. Construction school. Construction school. Ah, they did a poor banger job then. Okay. Ominous game is ominous. Oh, it is poison. Oh. The gutter. Really, game? Oh, and I'm dying of poison. Great. Really, game? Seriously? Oh, hello. Oh. Game. Oh, oh. Are these things doing that? Get span on. Game. Game, I wanna go back, game. I shouldn't have gone this way. Trying to look for the place of resisting. There's the boss. Can't really stand on that, it seems. Can't drop down there. I'm not gonna homeward bone for 600 souls. I'm not crazy. I can definitely experiment here. What do I want to try? I definitely can't stand on that thing. That's... yeah, I figured it's the statues. Stupid statues. Well, that was a nice gamble. All right, I'm gonna... travel back. And I'm gonna try the knight path. Gonna see if we can beat that knight, see where that leads. That gamble, though. That pixel health with gamble. Oh my god. Like, seriously? I got to one freaking 0.01 health. Am I glad I put a point in vigor last level up? Am I glad? Holy shit. Just need to take care of dealing with explodey dudes. Yeah. Oh. Oh. So where you land is also of influence. I see. And also, I should probably equip the cat ring for that part. I don't need the thing resist. Yeah, after some luck comes some bad luck, eh? There is that. The game was like, well, it's time for some bad luck. Time for some bad luck. I hope you guys are enjoying my crappy play. Yeah. After the great Red Vanguard fight, the pixelated health luck. I just grew bold, DG. I grew bold. I thought the game was having my back, you know? I think dropping down here is better because, yeah. All right. That's one. No pickup item, not yet. That's two. That's three. All right, cool. Charcoal pine resin. I assume that's fire damage. Get that damn lizardy thing. Oh man. If only. All right, let's try fighting this guy. Let's see what he has in store for us. Huh? Huh? What do you got? Now that we have a bonfire on the other side. Uh-oh. That's not too much damage. Why you no get crystal lizard? Because then I get exploded by the guys. Uh-oh. Okay, that was easy enough. Never say easy in Dark Souls. Oh, it's just a chest? Okay. So that's definitely the way forward. Sublime bone dust. The frick is sublime bone dust? Charred ashen bones. Cast them into the Farfire Medulla to increase the HP restored with each use of your flask. They say these are the remnants of Saint who cast himself into the bonfire. Some say these are the remains of a saint who cast himself into the bonfire. Others say he didn't cast himself into the bonfire. All we know, it's called sublime bone dust. It's sublime, that's what it is. Yeah. Retrieval of zero souls, yep. Well, Medulla is where we're going, guys. I'm going to use one of these. Medulla is where we're going, and then we're going to explore the Gata. Holy frick, the Gata. The Blighttown 2.0. It's real. Seriously? Some force has strengthened the Estus flask. Wait, twinkly twinkly lizard thingy is a real thing? Like, is a remaining thing? I thought it was just a random spawn that appeared once upon a time. Oh, and blacksmith! We can check out the blacksmith. Someone said to check out the blacksmith now that we're here. Gonna play some DS2? Ah! Good game.
I'd give you up for day. Who's had me?
Alright, what weapon do you have in store that is better than the Falquignon? Rapier? That's also a B. It's a D in strength. Yeah, that's better, right? Because of rapier. It's slightly less damage, but it's got a D in strength. This got an E in strength. So that means a rapier is better, right? I mean, my weapon's got different letters, probably. Because it's upgraded, but... No, it's still an E in strength. So maybe the rapier is better because it takes a bit more from strength. I don't know. Let's pocket it. Because why not?
What?
What? You again? Oh no. Everything else is a bit strength oriented, I think. Yeah, this is also a D in strength. Ooh, maybe a spear? I know, Blighttown with more projectile vomiting poison, wood constrict and darkness enough to let you see... to not let you see the bottom of the area. Yep, pretty much. Ooh, it's either a spear... A spear has less damage. The battle axe though. Yeah, but we're not a strength build, Sincarius. We're dex. We're dex focused. So a battle axe won't do any good because it's D dex and C strength. And we've got less strength than dexterity. I know a rapier is more. I don't know what's more important, the base damage or the scaling. Because if the scaling is more important, I'm switching to a rapier. A, B, C, D, E, yeah. Because that's one level higher than our Falchion in strength scaling. Which, even though we're not focused on it, we still have some. The spear is both the moveset of the rapier and the Falchion. Ooh. Ooh, definitely tempted to try that one out then. If it's versatility, I'll go with the spear. What do I decide on? Yeah, I don't know how these weapons play, that's the problem. I haven't played this before. Why not get both and test out the moveset? Yeah, we can only pay for one now, but we can definitely try the other one next time. Spear! Oh, if it's just like the Grand Lance, then bleh. But probably not. Woo! And you can poke whilst having the shield out. That's nice. And it's a wide arc sweep. Alright, it's not low to the ground against rats, but poking whilst having a shield up is pretty nice. And poke, and poke, and poke, and poke. Yeah, I'll try that for now. Let's go to the gutter. Ugh. It uses more stamina, yeah, than it does. But we'll just try it out in a real life situation, which is the gutter. Oh, yeah, I shouldn't try jumping on stuff that looks unjumpable. Oh well! At least I don't lose anything from dying. Because we just spend our souls. Sparta! Sparta! Oh, and they're kind to place our souls right here. Oh, there's definitely something in there. A dung pie. Oh, isn't that from Souls 1? Isn't that the same sort of thing? I don't know if it does the same, but I know there was a dung pie in Souls 1. This is Blighttown 2.0! Time to rage quit this game. Poisons foes, but also affects oneself. Oh, great. Rapier's pretty more for riposting pairing, which you rarely do. Right, okay. Cool, spear it is then. Surely construction work. Ah, they do need 3 steps to die though. But that's of course because the spear is unupgraded. Poison throwing knife? To kill the crystal lizard. Oh, that was not a chest at all. Oh man. We can always come back for the crystal lizard. I just wanna explore some gata for now. Man, I do like this poking style though. It's very, very pokey. Ooh, that was brutal, I know, right? Fatality. Oh, there we go. Oh, there's really nowhere to go from here. Really? Really, game? Really, did they just lock me up and go like, "Hey, you fell to the floor, rip, until next time"? Is that really a thing? What's that? Estos now stuck. Well, I definitely imagine Dark Souls. I can't even work on this. I clipped through this, look at that. Time to jump off a cliff. Well, not exactly. Maybe that fire back there might say. There you go! Yep, this just becomes more and more blight time to find out. It is. It is. I'm so gonna rage quit this game, man. God. Stupid blight time 2.0. I'm just moving towards the mist door. I hear something. Get wrecked, statues. Is that a dog? From somewhere? I don't trust those noises. Those sounds! Oh, we have to drop down here? I see what you're doing, game. Go here, and then through here it seems, and then we can climb up again. Something randomly died and gave astral souls. Yeah, it seems so, it seems so. Keep hearing sounds, oh god. Rip. Uh-oh. Oh, now it's 2 pokes. Okay. Oh, we have to move them there. Okay. At least there's only one direction to go, and it's not really as confusing as Blighttown was. Like, we have Blighttown, especially at the end, it was just one big swamp. And we were like, well, not sure what to do here. Remains a brutal animation. Look at all those items. The game lures you in with items. Look at this sea of items. Twinkling Titanite. Smooth and Silky Stone. Human Effigy. Smooth and Silky Stone. Fragrant Branch of Yore. Wow. That was a freaking treasure trove. Holy shit. Soul of a Nameless Soldier. Bring on the treasure! Rip all these statues. Oh, that was a jumping attack I didn't expect. Okay. Time to check and see. I did not forget. I just chose not to at this point in time. Wait, we came from up there. So that's definitely not the ladder to go down in. Do we have to just drop down here? Ooh, that was close. No, this is the same room. What the heck is that noise? We'll see, I'll try breaking those heart-shaped thingies. Oh, I'm so... curious, or not curious, but I was so cautious of it. Did we come from here? Yeah, we came from here. I just went all the way back. Oh no, this is Blighttown 2.0. Kill me now, please. Jeez. Oh, what the heck is that? Something terribly powerful. Something that's killing me. Jeez. I need to not go so close. I have a spear! I have reach on this guy! The heck? Got any torches? I do have torches. But now, I know where I fell down. And I'm going to avoid that. Ooh. Or at least, I'm going to assume that this is just like the other Dark Souls. And the part where the floor is open is where I fell down. Nah, I was a bit too close for my liking. I should have been further away. Poison statues. Gotta love that goring. Oh, poison statue. Oh, poison statue. Ugh. See, now we're moving up. In the world. Instead of going down, because we didn't fall down that one thing. But I don't know why we're doing that, because there's nothing here. Oh, yes, I'm going up. Going up, going up, going all the way. There. Oh, that does connect. Okay, cool. I thought it wouldn't connect because it was hung by a rope, but... Ow! Oh yeah, the game is tempting me to go down here. Look at that item in the jaw. In the jaw. Holy shit, what's that? Holy crap. Die, evil creature! Oh yeah, I'm liking the spear more and more, guys. This spear is nice. Spears! Black sludge. Alright, now I'm here. Sandworms instead of walls. Kinda, yeah. I'm going down. That's when I'm going. I mean, I'm going up right now, but eventually. Oh! Hey, that's the bonfire. Oh, I see. Best investment ever? Best investment ever! Oh shit. Yeah, well, we can't progress through here. And we're back to square one. Okay, I am totally lost, but we'll find out. We'll find it out. No worries. Because there's just no way down from here. I'm scanning along the edges with my eyes there. But no, there's no way down from here. It's, we're back to square one, guys. That's not the way. But it's also good timing on the game's part. Because my time's up. Expansible tapeworms, oh no! Ugh. Don't make me think about worms. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're totally lost and back at square one, but we have reached the gutter and killed the Red Vanguard. So even in a stream where the Dark Souls part was only 1 hour, we made some progress. This is my final stream, to let you know, my final solo stream. I shouldn't put this away yet, I needed to exit the game. But this was my final solo stream in a long while. I don't know when I shall return with solo streams, but I think if you start counting from next week, 2 or 3 weeks is a good estimate. 2 to 3 weeks should be a good estimate if you're starting to count from next week. My time's up, Astral Seconda. Many a times in this game, Syncarius. Many a times. Yeah. Even though this is not my final farewell, I still want to say thank you everyone on Twitch or on YouTube if you're watching this on YouTube. Thank you everyone for the support you have been showing me 2 to 3 decades. No! I will not be 60 before I return. Streaming my holodeck. No, streaming from my holodeck. No, thank you everyone for showing the support that you have during these 2.5 years of streaming so far. About 2.5 years-ish. 2 years and a bit. It sounds like I'm quitting forever, but I'm not. But I still want to thank you guys. Still want to take this chance to thank you all guys on YouTube, on Twitch, who have been following me and watching me for the past 2.5 years. A retirement stream. Oh, please no. So much feels. I will be back, though. This is not a retirement stream. But I still want to say thank you to everyone. You've given me a lot of awesome chats, awesome moments that I wouldn't have had if I would have played these kinds of games solo on my own. It's definitely a reason why I picked the games I picked to play on Twitch. It's the games where chat gets fired up on and gets discussing about, because that's what Twitch is about by me, for me, is having the community. That's the reason why I play on Twitch instead of playing solo. I also play solo, but that's the reason why I do play games on Twitch rather than playing them solo, is the community. And you guys have given me that so far, so thank you all so much for that. It was a great first part, shall we say, of my streaming career. Let's put this out as a end of the first part of my streaming career and pick it up at the second part. Once again, do know that I will still be on Twitch, even on this channel, with Friday evenings, Bookfish, 35's, Total War, Warhammer Duo streams. Skipping this week, but starting next week, I will still be online on this channel on Friday evenings. And I will also appear on Twitch during Rats in the Basement, our D&D campaign, which is hosted over at twitch.tv/bookfish35. I'll type it in chat just cause. twitch.tv/bookfish35. But this is, for now, the end of my first chapter of solo streams. I will be returning once I have found my way into the world and found my scheduling with my new job. And I will, of course, be returning probably with a show that actually has a scheduling. I know. It's mind blowing. Who is this book? Come on, DG. You definitely know well enough who Bookfish is. She's an awesome caster, my sister, and host to our D&D campaign. This Saturday, actually, we have our next session. So if you want to swing by this Saturday, 8 p.m. Central European Summer Time is the way to do it. Or is the time to do it, as we will be having our next session. As the party is clearing out a nest of goblins and hobgoblins and all sorts of foul creatures, as they decided to charge in there and fight instead of actually talking. Which they could have done, to be fair. They could have talked and made it a diplomatic/roleplay sort of thing, but they just decided to charge in there and kick their ass, which made it a combat thing. So that's what's happening. Twice removed the 35th of the Noble Fish Books. Yes. Indeed. Twice removed would make her the 37th of the Noble Fish Books. Disgusting! RS Prof, welcome to the Prof Ads. And thank you so much for the follow and the support. Oh, B3 Prof. Welcome. Sorry, I thought it was RS. My screen didn't really show well enough. B3 Prof, welcome. Yeah, so, once again, to end it off on, thank you all so much for the support you've given me so far. And I shall return with a scheduled show. I promise you that when I return from my settling in phase of my new job, I will have a scheduled show scheduled around when I am available, and also bonus weekend streams on these sorts of time zones for those that cannot make it for the evening streams. There you go. So even if you cannot make it to the scheduled evening streams, do not despair, because I will make sure that I'll be streaming on my regular Astral Games Day time zone, or mornings even, even pushing it back a bit further for those that cannot make it. So I'll be having episodes all around for everyone to enjoy. just like the Terminator, Astro will be Bach. Yes, I will write the greatest composition the world has ever heard, and I will return with the classical singer on stream, and I will just... No, just kidding. Yes. I will be back, indeed. And, yeah. I don't know what's left to say. These are the words. Thank you. That's all I can say. I mean, I want to say more things that express the gratitude that I feel towards you guys for being such an awesome community, but I can't. I can't. Sorry. Astral Schwarzenegger will be back. 30 years! Come on, DG. Come on. It's not gonna be that bad. It's gonna be a few weeks. And I'm still here, like I said, on Friday evenings. That's gonna happen next week. End it with an Astral Seer-esque quote. To be... to gaze or not to gaze. That's the question. Will you gaze into the stars to find your destiny or not? No, that was too cheesy. something, keep looking at the stars. Something, I will be watching something. Well, I will still be watching other streamers when I can, so I will be in their chats. If you ever want to chat with me, I will not disappear from Twitch in that sense. And I will obviously be in my normal streamers' stream chatters when I can. Avert thine eyes, you saucy boy. What? Avert thine eyes. Yeah, it's... But it's been great. In short, in closing, it's been great. You guys especially made it great. I remember starting this stream with Bookfish 35 in a co-op Starbound stream. And I also remember my XCOM playthrough, XCOM Enemy Unknown, where most of the current community picked up my channel, I think? I'm thinking here. I'm not pretty sure who joined when, but I know that during XCOM and after that time, there was definitely a big... a joining of the channel, channels, a growing of the channel's community. To gaze or not to gaze, the chest be too tempting. Insert Ludi right here. Yes. Those were fun times. I remember my brother's Tale of Two Sons stream. I know there are people in there who don't want spoilers, but it was one of the greatest streams I did, I think. There was... What else were highlights? Jeez. I think Total War was a definite highlight in terms of... chatter activity. There were times where my chat went so fast that I couldn't even keep up, which was pretty interesting. I just remembered, so Astral still has continued XCOM 2. Damn timers. If there is a mod out there that removes the timers... The meta timers, I mean, for missions. Then I will continue. Darn it. Stupid timers in that game. But those totally turned me off. I like to take my time and strategize, but darn it. What else is there? There were so much highlights, though. But yeah, thank you. Thank you all so much. And I will see you on the other end, in the chat. And yeah, take care. And game on, as always. Game on. Game on. And I will be back. You are not prepared.